لا
إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستهديه ونؤمن به ونتوكل عليه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا. من يهده الله فهو المهتد، ومن يضلل فلن تجد له وليا مرشدا. ونشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، ونشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله وصفيه وخليله، أدى الأمانة وبلغ الرسالة ونصح الأمة وكشف الله به الغمة وجاهد في الله حق جهاده حتى أتاه اليقين. فصلوات الله وسلامه عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه وعلى من اتبعهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين. أما بعد، فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله عز وجل، وخير الهدي هدي سيدنا محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم، وشر الأمور محدثاتها، وكل محدثة بدعة، وكل بدعة ضلالة، وكل ضلالة في النار. اللهم أجرنا من النار. اللهم إنا نسألك الجنة وما يقرب إليها من قول أو عمل، ونعوذ بك من النار وما يقرب إليها من قول أو عمل. يقول الله عز وجل: يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله، اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. ويقول عز وجل: يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء، واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام، إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. My dear respected brothers and sisters, we are knocking the doors of Ramadan al-Mubarak. Ramadan, it comes only once a year. And one of the most beloved month in the sight of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is Shahru Ramadan. Shahru Ramadan alladhi unzila fihi al-Qur'an. Because it's so dear and precious. This month Allah has made it and He loves it so much, He revealed on it His word. إِنَّا أَنزَلْنَاهُ فِي لَيْلَةٍ مُبَارَكَةٍ. We have revealed the Quran on one of the blessed days, Laylatul Qadr. As Muslims, to be honest with you, when I looked at the virtues of Ramadan and Siyam, wallahi, to be honest with you, there is a saying of one of the tabi'in. He says, if the Muslims only know the blessings of Ramadan and the virtues of Ramadan, they would have asked that the whole year become Ramadan, which is not what Allah intended. If you look at Ramadan and Siyam, you found that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He says, which is amazing. We have to tadabbur of the Quran. Many Muslims, for example, they may think this is Shahrul Mashaqqa. This is difficulty. It's Ramadan and the fasting will take me away from what I want to do. I want to be free and I want to do this. But actually it's the contrary. If you look at the verses of the Quran when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned in Surah Al-Baqarah, there's one page. There's not other about Siyam and Ramadan. It's mentioned only one time in Surah Al-Baqarah. And in the end, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He says, وَلَعَلَّكُمْ تَشْكُرُونَ. He says, in order, and I'm going to go back, this is the end, when Allah finishes the virtues of Ramadan and what the Siyam is doing. وَأَن تَصُومُوا خَيْرٌ لَكُمْ. Allah is, and He says, أَيَّامًا مَعْدُودَاتٍ, just in numbers of days. And He keeps talking about Ramadan and to make us, He's our Khaliq. He's the creator of human being. He knows that there is a little bit of mashaqqa, there is a little bit of struggle that you got to do, that you have to adjust your life. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the end says, this is good for you. لَعَلَّكُمْ تَتَّقُونَ. In order for you to gain piety, the whole creation, the purpose of the creation of the human being is to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, is to worship the creator of the universe.
But الشياطين and the devils are taking us and snapping us away from Allah. And Allah loves His people. إن الله لا يرضى لكم الكفر. Allah does not want you to disbelieve. Allah is begging the people for Jannah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He says, listen, wallahi, it's amazing to see Allah is begging. He's the creator. He's the owner of the universe. He's the self-sufficient. As-samad. You know what is the word as-samad? He's لا يحتاج إلى أي أحد. This is the word samad. قل أعوذ برب الفلق. It means samad الذي لا يحتاج. ورغم ذلك, still Allah is begging. He's happy when you do this. And He's telling you the ways to stay away from shaitan and to get away. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala astonishing, He says, وَيُرِيدُ اللَّهُ بِكُمُ الْيُسْرِ in the surah of Siyam. Allah wants to make easy for you. Well, a long time ago, I was thinking, يعني, what is... Allah asked me to fast, especially in the summer. So many days, so many hours. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He says, I want to make it easy for you. What is this easy that Allah is talking? He's talking about the hellfire and the day of judgment. And also, fasting, it has a benefit, physical, mental, spiritual benefit. Today, there is clinic. Wallahi, it's amazing. And we as Muslims, we don't fast because we recently they found that fasting cure some of the most difficult diseases of the body. Some of them are cancer cells. They are killed. And I did a lot of research. What is this? Subhanallah, so Ramadan, it's a school, it's a university. That is going to clean up your mental and spiritual and physical. So you are going to benefit. So that's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He says, وَأَنْ تَصُومُوا خَيْرٌ لَكُمْ. Look, if Allah, the one who knows the good and the bad, He says, if you fast, it's better for you. Imagine Allah, the one who created the body. Now, recently, the science, they found out that fasting is a good, and they have this water fasting, and they have clinics that they teaches the people how to do this. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala was doing this for us for a long time. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He says again, on the same surah, I'm just within the context, Allah wants to make it easy for you. There is another ayah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He says, Allah, يُرِيدُ اللَّهُ أَن يُخَفِّفَ عَنْكُمْ. This is all the ayat concerning Siyam. Allah wants to make it easy for you. Allah wants to repent on you. Another ayah. وَيُرِيدُ اللَّهُ أَن يَتُوبَ عَلَيْكُمْ. Because Ramadan is the month of Tawbah. And you can see it clearly. And I'm going to tell you why. Not me, the hadith. قَالَ اللَّهُ قَالَ رَسُولُهُ. That's why in Ramadan you see people, wallahi, comes from nowhere. Jumu'ah, it's full. The Salat al-Tarawih. Ramadan, this month al-Mubarak, can transform the heart of the human being. You have to be ready to accept it. So that's why now the a'imma of the manabir, of course, we don't forget our brothers and sisters and all over the world that they are suffering and are struggling. And the reason we are suffering as an ummah because we are deviated from the path of Allah. وَمَا أَصَابَكُم مِّن مُصِيبَ فَبِمَا كَسَبَتْ أَيْدِيكُمْ وَيَعْفُ عَنْ كَثِيرٍ. This is Allah. He says, any musibah, any trials, any tribulation that falls upon you, bima kasabat aydikum, because of your hand, what possess every mistake, every calamity that falls upon human beings because of them. Because every woman ya'mal su'an yujza bihi.